Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Do you have any rooms available for tonight?
A single?
Yes, please. I told you, we're coming to a deadline. There's no coverage here.
I know, I'm just trying to get a hold of Peter and Anne. They're coming on a bike and they should be here by now.
You feel vulnerable without your beloved Anne? You know, they act like lovers, really.
Very funny, John.
They get lost. They'll be devoured by the witches of the forest.
Not if you want, but I read on the internet that this forest is full of folktales of people disappearing. It's not a good place to get lost.
Talking about lost people, are you okay, John?
Yeah. According to what the lady said at the hotel, we should be near the site by now.
Okay. I hope there aren't any wolves.
Ow, ow, ow!
Jerks.
Hey, what's with the house?
I don't know. Maybe someone lives there, eh?
Don't think so. Looks abandoned.
Maybe.
You'd rather stay here than go out. To tell you the truth, I never go out at night around here. Yes. Nothing's changed. You have to be careful not to succumb to the temptation.
What do you know about this?
About what?
About what the paper says. A girl disappeared in the neighboring town.
Worrying.
Has that before?
Yes, unfortunately. It's becoming more common. I forgot. It's for you. I kept it for when you would return.
Guys. Have you seen the house?
What house?
This house. It is so creepy. It gives me the shivers.
Hey, Nolan. Now that you're single, maybe you can find a girlfriend out here.
Yeah. The fucking Blair Witch. What I need is to find inspiration to compose something new.
Yeah. I need something good to write.
And I need something worth taking a photo of. Guys? Have you noticed how romantic we are? We're like Shelley, Byron, and Polidori, all gathered at the shore of a mysterious lake.
We're the haunted house.
Oh. Very romantic, Harriet. Very romantic. Hey, Harriet, if you want some romance later, just let me know, yeah?
Grow up first.
Ooh.
Hey, chum. Okay. Tomorrow we'll hit the lake. See if we can find some inspiration there. Or maybe that cemetery that it says nearby.
I hope they get here tomorrow. I'm worried.
I'm sure they're fine, okay? That Peter, that bastard. Finally, what's all that romance?
Shh, there's people outside.
What? Come on, let's go back to sleep.
The man has finished fixing the boiler. He said it should work much better now.
Let's hope so. Pay him and thank him. Please.
The photographs again?
In the 19th century, it was quite commonplace to have your photograph taken with the dead. It was a work of art. During the Renaissance, they did it with paintings. Memento mori.
Do you think the youngsters will be okay in the forest?
I hope so.
How are you feeling?
Better. But you know what Howard's like. It's not easy missing someone so much.
I know.
Anyway, thanks, Harriet, for arranging all this. I know this isn't just about playing Byron and shelling Polidori.
Actually, it was John's idea. He's worried about you. In his own way, but he is.
Thank you. your name?
Ted.
I'm Ted.
Thank you, Ted. I went for a walk and I just set my ankle.
You're not British, are you?
Why do you ask?
You don't seem to be. So where are you from?
If I told you, you wouldn't believe me.
Try me.
What for? Drive and take me home. Maybe later I will find a way.
Seems you're not fond with this kind of trips. Don't worry.
Well, it is a weird place to live.
Don't these kind of things excite you? This is my living room. Do you like it?
Not as much better than the rest of the house.
Make yourself comfortable.
Elegant.
I told you I will find a way to thank you.
I was wondering.
Wondering?
Yeah. I'm not assuming you tell me your secrets, but,
ask.
Do I have a limited number of questions?
There is a limited number of answers.
Do you live here all by yourself?
I usually have visitors.
What is it you do for a living?
I'm always looking for people. Looking for interesting people. You are interesting, but you have to accept me for who I am.
I'm sorry.
Thank you.
Why can't you come back to bed?
Help me, please. I'm hurt.
Are you sure you can do it yourself? I'm sorry, I don't have a first aid kit.
You have tape or something? I've got tools in my car, but not for this. I think I drank something. That was broken glass.
Does anyone live in that house?
I asked myself the same thing.
Breakfast on a small table, not wanting to leave her for even a moment. While peeling fruit, I accidentally gave myself a deep cut. The blood ran in crimson drops, and some of them landed on her. Then, her eyes regained their sheen, and I noticed in her face a wild expression of fierce joy, which I had not seen on her before. She jumped from the bed with animal agility and pounced on my wound, sucking it with indescribable voluptuousness.
Bring some guests.
me and my son friends of flowers. I'm sorry, but I had to go out of town last night. You're still here, at least.
I had a nightmare. Or at least I think I did. I woke up and you weren't there. Wait, so where did you find this book?
I told you, right here on the floor. That man must have dropped it.
The author, it sounds familiar, right?
Mm. Hey, the Good Samaritan. She doesn't even know his name, do you?
I don't know, he didn't tell me. Drop the suspicion, okay? Are you, like, jealous or something?
Yeah, jealous about picking up injured people. Good one, Harriet. Very jealous. Hey.
Easy. Guys.
Well, the important thing is the book. Since we have it, I thought we could use it as a good source of inspiration for the next couple of days. According to what I read here in the introduction, this is one of the first known works of people coming out of their graves and drinking people's blood.
People drinking other people's blood?
Anyway, the story is from 1836, and it's about this man who falls madly in love with this woman on the same day he takes his vows to be ordained. The woman is what he calls creature of the devil, and she manages to tempt him, take him to Venice, and make him her lover, feeding off him by drinking his blood.
I'm sorry, but this is the only thing we have to drink. Red wine. But of a very good quality.
Do you like it?
Excellent.
It's good. Our guests always like it. Ted likes it too. Don't you, Ted?
Can I make a phone call? My son doesn't.
No, I'm afraid not. We don't have a telephone in the house.
Nope. Well, it doesn't matter. It's just that we're supposed to meet up with some friends, and I wanted to let them know we'd be late.
I'm sorry. I feel a bit guilty.
Well, since we are here, I suggest a toast. To the night.
To the night.
To the night. Things happening in places like this. A tent, couple, forest.
Couple.
Thank you.
You're playing a dangerous game. You've never done anything like this before. Kill him before it's too late.
What an early bird you are, miss. I came to take some photos. You enjoying your stay? Such a beautiful place.
It's beautiful and mysterious.
Oh, yes. Okay, so I had this idea of how to tell a story of the book through a series of photos, using the people around here as models. Some of them are really weird.
Yeah, I'm quite inspired too, but I didn't ask you that. I'm asking about John.
Oh. Okay. He's always flirting. He loves it. He's been doing it for ages, ever since I met him.
Come on. There must be something you can do.
We'll see.
Thank you.
It's a booby trap. What were you doing here?
I was looking for Rupert.
Rupert? You didn't look too good last night. I will send you prayer. But just this one time.
What women are you talking about?
The ones in the house. I bet they know what happened to Peter and Anne. Because something bad has happened.
Okay, are you sure about this helmet? There must be hundreds like it.
I'm sure. What do I have to do to convince you?
Okay, look, I'll go look for the helmet. You stay here. You crazy? When I woke up and you weren't there, I knew exactly where you'd gone.
Those women, they sleep in the basement.
We can't get out of here, Harriet.
No, not without our friends.
We don't know where our friends are. All we know is he didn't come back last night. We've got to get out of here. Come on.
Could try to get to that town and ask for help.
Better if we wait. We're too far away, and that forest...
Okay, just for tonight. If they don't show up in the morning, we're leaving. Okay?
I still remember your taste. So deep. So intense. I'm so hungry.
Do you like pleasure? We have to learn to enjoy small pleasures. Don't you think? Life is so short. Especially yours.
Okay, I'll be right back. Done.
humidanie, that as with animals, human flesh is tastier the praise is killed. And that's what we're going to do with you. Make it tastier. Do you hear me?
Thank you.
I was waiting for you. Hello, hello.
How are you?
Hello. You won't regret buying this house. Are the stories real? What stories? Ghost stories. They say it has a dark past, that it's haunted.
Fantasma.
I love them. But don't worry about it. Every old house has its mysteries.
En realidad, lo que a ti te encantaría es tener un fantasma en casa.
Ahora sale el humor español. Seriously, though, the only thing that's important is that be habitable. You will be the first in many years. It's been empty for decades.